All right. Some people had asked about my 39-gallon water tank. I thought a video might do better than pictures. So this is my 95, or what at one time was a 95 Coleman Cape Cod. So what we did, okay, this is the 39-gallon water tank. It's got welded this cross beam, which goes up. And it's a little difficult to see. There you go. It's welded to the frame there and there. Goes across. It's welded the same on the other side. It's got these two upright beams on both sides of it to keep it from shifting around. And then I put a piece of 3/4-inch plywood, painted it, so it'd be a little bit more protected from the elements underneath it. This here is the drain. It's just 1/2-inch flex line with this is actually PEX, but that's because I couldn't find one that was a barb for the 1/2-inch line that was the ball valve. I should probably use something other than zip ties on it. So that's from this view. Let me crawl underneath there and show you the rest of it. All right, so this tank came with sensors, fill sensors, so you can see the yellow, the green, and the red, and maybe it's orange, sensors, which is the low, medium, and full, with the white ground. It's a little tight. I should probably, there we go. Which go to my fill indicator. Here's the 1/2-inch line from the pump, my freshwater fill. This is the air vent, which goes up to my freshwater fill port. This really doesn't have to, but the water has a place to go. So that you can drain it, this sits a little bit lower, which is nice. And then I had to cut out the plywood, and then it's got this plumber strap. It's pretty well wedged in there, but just in case it were to move forward, it's gonna prevent the pump, you know, the tank from moving what, more than 3/4 of an inch, an inch or so. So that's my freshwater tank setup. Could definitely shorten this hose a little bit. I think that's about it. Should you have any questions, please feel free to leave a comment.